Today's question is, design a program when an input A is on, light L should be on for 10 seconds. Later, it will be off. So, when an input A is given, your light should be on for 10 seconds. And after 10 seconds, light should be in off condition. So, as it is mentioned 10 seconds, we need to use a timer. So here I am using on delay timer. This is your input A and on delay timer is taken and a time delay of 10 seconds is being set. As you know, this on delay timer means when you are giving input, after 10 seconds only the output coil will be energized. But our condition is we need to turn on our output for next 10 seconds. So I am taking just opposite, normally closed contact, and taking the feedback of timer. So when you are giving input, the timer will start count, but after 10 seconds only its coil is becoming high. So I have taken a normally closed contact and connected to our output. After 10 seconds your output should be in off condition. We'll simulate and see. Can see here the timer starts running, your output is in on condition. When it is becoming 10 seconds, your output has become off. And our next question is a continuation of this program, that is, design a program when input A is on, light L should be on for 10 seconds. Later it will be off for 2 seconds and again it will on continuously until a stop button is pressed. So you are giving an input A, your bulb or LED should be on for 10 seconds. For that you will be using a on delay timer. Again it should be off for 2 seconds. After 2 seconds, it should be on continuously until a stop button is pressed. So, first on, then off, then continuously on. That is our condition. So, I am making changes in this same diagram. So, 10 seconds, it is already been set. Now we need to set for extra 2 seconds. So one more timer I am taking for setting 2 seconds delay. Here I have taken on delay timer only. So once this timer 1 completes 10 seconds, this timer 2 needs to count 2 seconds. So I am taking timer feedback. T01 feedback I am taking. It is connected to your timer 2. So once it complete 10 seconds, T01, this coil will be energized, it will close and this it will start counting 2 seconds. So here already we are connected this one. We can see here when it completes 10 seconds it will be off. And after 2 seconds, we need to turn on your Q1. So what we'll do means, we'll be taking the feedback of T002 and connecting it parallel with T001. T002 feedback I will take. This will be connected in parallel with T001. Actually, it is a OR condition. Starting T01 should work, next T02 should work. And as mentioned, there is a stop button. So we need to give a stop button here. Suppose you are pressing that stop button, the whole operation should be suspended. So another input I2 I am giving as stop. We'll simulate and see whether it is working. So I'm turning on I1 for 10 seconds. The bulb will be glowing. You can see here the count. 2 seconds, it should be off. 2 seconds, here it is off. Again, there's turn on continuously. When we are pressing stop button, it will go to off condition. So once again, I'll simulate and see. Turning on for 10 seconds, it is in on condition. Seconds off condition, then on. Stop button pressing, everything is in the off position.